Hey everyone, Rodney here from Cleves Tech, and today I'm going to be discussing something that I get a lot in the comments and I see discussed and asked a lot on Reddit and other places, and that is about using Stable Diffusion 1.5 in Fooocus. And yes, it can be used in Fooocus. It's designed for SDXL. There is a way of using SD 1.5 in Fooocus. Pretty simple to do. It's not the same as using 1.5 in other user interfaces, so you're going to probably get slightly different results, but it will work. I can't really tell you about comparable results, which works better with or without, you know, using another UI, because I don't use Stable Diffusion 1.5 an awful lot. I personally prefer SDXL, but this will allow, if you have certain LoRAs or anything else that you want to use as 1.5, you can use them. First thing you want to know is if we go into the model tab under Fooocus, you're going to notice at the top here, this base model, and it says SDXL only. That must be an SDXL model. You can pick whichever one you want, but it has to be an SDXL one. That's what it starts off with. Over on the refiner slot, though, you'll see it says SDXL or SD 1.5. Now, here's where you put the SD 1.5. You'll choose this in the dropdown, which I don't have one in here yet, and I'll show you how to the best way to do that. And it's the same thing with the LoRAs. Now, if I were to go and use a 1.5 LoRa here with an SDXL, it's not going to work, but if I use an SD 1.5 in the refiner slot, then I can use a LoRa that is SD 1.5. The first thing is to get a 1.5 model to use. Now, I prefer Civit AI. If you go on to the main site here and then you go under models and then choose under filters, we have checkpoint, and then I have SD 1.5 version checked here. And then I get my selection. We're just gonna go ahead with this one here to start off with, just as an example. You'll notice on here, it says base model 1.5. So that's what you're gonna be looking for. We're gonna click on the download. Now in here, we have different ones, the pruned and full model. I'm not gonna get into all those. We're gonna go with the full model, and there's two options here. It doesn't show you what these are, but these are actually different file formats. And once you click on them, you'll discover which one it is. It could be the checkpoint or the safe tensor file. And Fooocus does seem to work with either one, but the safe tensors are gonna be a better file format and safer to use. So that's the one you wanna be getting. So if we click on this one, I believe the first one here, yeah, it's the dot safe tensors. In our Fooocus folder here, you're gonna be going into the models folder and then under checkpoints. Now you could just put it into here, and if you're only gonna be using a few models, probably not a big deal. But I find the easiest way to make this a lot simpler to keep track of what is a 1.5 model and what's not is once I'm in my checkpoint folder, I'm just going to click on new folder here, and I'm just going to put 1.5, and that's it. And then I'll put that in the subfolder, and now we will wait for it to download. Okay, so our model is now downloaded, and we do not need to refresh. All we need to do is click on refresh all files down here. Once we do that, it should show up in this box here. And as you can see, I labeled the folder 1.5, and you can label it whatever you want. It shows that before the model. That way I know that's a 1.5 model. Just makes it easier. Now, once you select something in the refiner, you get this switch, this slider here where you can change. Now, this is where it switches from the base model to the refiner. So at 0.5, that's 50%. So halfway through the steps. So if it's set at 30 steps, when it gets to 15 steps, it's gonna switch over to the SD 1.5. There are recommendations in here. I kind of play with these myself whenever I use SD 1.5, which as I said, is pretty minimal. So I can't tell you what you're gonna get for the best results from this. I say, give it a shot with what they recommend and then experiment. So let's say I wanted it to start be almost all the 1.5. I could go way down if I want to. So we're gonna, for this one, I'm just gonna go with the default one they recommend here, just to demonstrate that it works. So now we have our base model in, our refiner model in there, and we have the switch set, refiner switch at about 40%. I'm not gonna have any LoRAs at the moment. I will just disable most of these styles. And I'm gonna leave that, well, let's put this on the quality just so it's easier to see where it switches. And I'm gonna go ahead and just put a cat. Let's just go ahead and generate. Now, as this is going, you're gonna notice about 40%, this will pause right there, and then it's going to continue. Now that's where it switched over to the SD1.5. The lower you put that, the more it's going to rely on the SD1.5. So if that were to switch at 10%, it's going to be almost all based on the SD1.5. And I'll show you that in a moment, how that would work. So that we'll stop that here. So we have our cat. So that's the basics of how you use SD1.5 with Fooocus. Now, if I were to put this way down here, and then we start to generate, let's give this a shot now. We're going to notice as soon as it starts, within a few steps, right there, 7, boom, it kicks over. And it allows 1.5 to take control at that point. The later you make this switch, the more SDXL is going to be have the greater influence than the SD1.5 will. Okay, so that's the basics of using SD1.5 with Fooocus. Now let's go into a little bit more. I'm going to put this back up to 4. We haven't talked about LoRAs or anything else yet. As far as the LoRAs go, we're going to go ahead. I went ahead, same idea. I did a search, found a LoRa. I'm going to go with this one here because it's safer for YouTube, whereas a lot of the LoRAs for SD1.5, I can't really demonstrate on YouTube. This one shows base model SD1.5, so that's what we're going to be using. And we're going to go ahead and download this. It's a safe tensors one. Now, if you get it in a different format, I don't think it will work under the LoRAs. I haven't fully tested. Most of them are safe tensors that I've tried. Same idea. Now, we need to get out of this folder and go to the models folder again. But instead of the checkpoints, we're going into the LoRAs. And we can do the same thing in here. We can put 1.5. And then I'll save it in this folder. And now I know in the interface that the 1.5 is in there. So let's go over to Fooocus. We're gonna hit refresh all models down here. And now we should, you'll see here, it says 1.5 and then ribbon logo. This makes it a lot easier to keep track of which ones of your LoRAs are 1.5 and which ones are SDXL. Okay, so everything is set up. We have our LoRa selected. I've set the slider down, refiner switch to a real low amount so it can take over pretty quickly. As I said, that's entirely up to you. Experiment with that. I'm not sure what's best. I've gone with a simple vector art style here, and we'll go for 4 images. I've added a negative prompt in here, and for our prompt, I have ribbon logo, which is the trigger word for that LoRa. Deer, dark background, centered. See our results. Okay, we have our ribbon logos. A couple of these are okay, a couple not. Anyways, that's how the LoRAs work with SD1.5. Well, that should get you started using SD1.5 with Fooocus. And if you found this video helpful, please hit the like button so others might discover it as well. For anyone that uses Fooocus with SD1.5 and has any tips for getting best results, please leave a comment for others. Thank you to everyone that has donated to help the channel, because it really does make up for the little that I do get from YouTube itself. And I would like to thank everyone who has subscribed and gotten this channel to 10,000 subscribers. Now go have fun creating.